This is Math Studies Lesson 8.3, and in this lesson we're going to get more into some algebra. We're going to start writing some functions, some equations, to model data in exponential form. So, an exponential equation, I'm going to write it a couple different ways, but if you want to think about a traditional y equals equation, they're in the form a times b. And I'll do a times like that, a times b to the power of x. If we want to use more traditional function notation, f of x instead of y equals, a is the y-intercept, or the starting value. And so in function notation, that is f of 0. Wherever x is 0, the corresponding y value, that is your intercept, your starting value. B is the ratio between terms, and so if you remember sequences, we took the second term divided by the first term to get the ratio between terms. Second term divided by first term. If I want to use more function notation, that would be f of n over, I'm totally out of space. Times f of n over f of n minus 1. So that's the second term divided by the first term, or the third term divided by the second term, any term divided by the term in front of it, the one in front of it. And then we're going to do that to the power of x. So this is a lot simpler, my first y equals version, but if we want to get technical, we have the function version as well. But, so we need to get the starting value, the ratio between the terms, to the power of x, that's my equation, and then I can always substitute values in for x to solve or evaluate my equations. So my first example is going to ask me to find the ratio. In my y equals equation, that's my b value. To get my b value, I need to take my second value divided by my first value. So I can pick any two consecutive values. I can do 10 over 4. I could also do 25 over 10. I could even do 62.5 over 25. It just has to be two terms that are right next to each other, two consecutive terms, and whichever pair I pick, I get the same answer. So my ratio is 2.5. When I'm writing my y equals equation then, that's the value that's going to go where my ratio is in my parentheses. Now the a parameter in my equation is the y-intercept, or the starting value, and we find that wherever x is 0, so here's where my x is 0, so then that is going to be my intercept, my starting term. So I have my completed equation, y equals 4 times 2.5 to the power of x, 4 is my starting ratio, or starting term, and 2.5 is my ratio. And if I wanted to find the 10th value, f of 10, I can substitute the 10 in for x, so that would be 4 times 2.5 to the power of 10. And I have my handy dandy written on calculator. That will be 4 times 2.5 to the power of 10, and I have 38,147. Continuing on to example B, write an exponential equation to answer the question. Part A says John received $7 for allowance this week. His mom says he will double his allowance every week. How much will John get for allowance in 4 weeks? So I need to know two things. I need to know where I'm starting and what my ratio is. I started with $7, and my ratio is that I am doubling. Doubling means you're multiplying by 2. So my equation will be 7 times 2, and we need to know how much time goes by. It says 4 weeks, so that will be my exponent. 7 times 2 to the power of 4. It looks like John will be getting $112 for allowance in 4 weeks. Part B says, Carla is determined to make her favorite shampoo last. The bottle has 2 ounces left, and she plans to use a fourth of the remaining shampoo each day. How much will remain after 1 week? Now this one's a little tricky. We know how much we're starting with. We're starting with 2 ounces. But the question doesn't ask how much she's using. The question asks how much is remaining. So we need to think, if she's using a fourth, that means 3/4 remains. So for my B term, I'm going to use the decimal 0.75 to show that 75% or 3/4 is remaining every single day. So my equation is 2.75 to the x, and how much remains after 1 week? 1 week is 7 days, so I will sub 7 into my equation. After 7 days, she will have about 1/4 ounce left, 0.27 ounces. Letter C is asking us to solve some exponential equations. Now, we will learn how to solve these equations using the symbolic method in a later lesson. At this point, we're just going to use some guessing, some checking, and some calculator tools to help us get these answers. So, 3 to the power of x means 3 times itself. How many times is going to give me 81? Well, I can do this recursively if I remember how to do that. 3 times itself, 2 times, 3 times, 4 times. It took me 4 times to get to 81, so I know x is 4. I could do this using guess and check. I already know the answer is 4, but let's pretend I didn't, and I tried 3 to the 2, and that was too low. And I tried 3 to the 8, and, well, that's way too high, so I'm going to try 3 to the 4, and looky there, I got the right answer. So we could also use our calculators if we know how to work our tables and our graphs. I'm going to put my equation in to the y equals, and I will go to my table, and I'm just kind of looking until I see 81, and I see 81 right there. I had 3 different ways that I got the answer is x equals 4. And we would be doing the same thing with our next one. 16 times itself, how many times is going to get me to 2? Well, if I do 16 times itself any number of times, it's getting bigger. And so if I'm trying to get a smaller number, the recursive formula way doesn't really work for me. So maybe I'll just try doing some guessing and checking. So I know I'm not going to keep going up, because once I got to 2 or 3, I'm already in the thousands. So how about we go down instead? How about we go to negative 1? And, well, that's not right. How about we go to negative 5? That's getting even weirder, so I don't think that's going to be right. How about I try a decimal? And that's looking better, because 2 is pretty close to 4. So guess and check can get kind of tedious if we don't want to go with that method. I like the table. And again, I'm just looking for 2, but, you know, this doesn't really help me because I figured out it was a decimal and my table's only going to be whole numbers. If you know how to work your table setup, we can go by different quantities. If you don't really know how to work your table setup, I would probably keep going with guess and check. And I know it's in between 0.2 and 0.3. I betcha. We got it. So if this is kind of tedious, I understand. But in a lesson or two, we'll talk about how to solve these using the symbolic method, so there's no more guessing and checking. But for now, We just want to give this a try. Come on. So my hint is when you're guessing and checking, if it's getting bigger, you know, a whole number is good. Like example A. If it's getting smaller, a decimal is good. And if you're working with any fractions, we're going to be working with negatives. Now, I know, just because I know, that 2 to the 5 is 32. So 1 over 2 to the 5, if I stick a negative on that 5, it's going to give me 32. So when you're working with fractions, negatives are a good way to go. When you're getting smaller, decimals are a good way to go. When you're getting bigger, positives are a good way to go. Okay, this was a really long video. Sorry about that. That's it for the notes, though. Good luck on the exercises, and please let me know if you have questions.